Hi guys, welcome to our channel Humpty Dumpty 2. So in today's video, I will be talking about WES, World Education Services. This is one of the very famous organizations for ECA qualification. So in this video, we will discuss in detail the step-by-step process, how you can apply for WES, what are the prerequisites and what are the do's and don'ts that you should consider when you're going ahead with WES. So guys, before we get started, click on the subscribe button to get subscribed and tuned to our channel, and also click the bell icon next to it so that you get notification of all our videos because we create a lot of videos on Canada PR. All right, so let's get started. First thing I want to share is WES is actually one of the most favorite organizations which is considered by people, majorly because of two factors. One is the processing time for WES is very fast. There are many other EC organizations, but they take a lot of time in evaluating your credentials. But WES is the only organization which is actually very quick. They have published the timeline of 35 days that they say that, you know, they can give you the ECA. And second is they have an excellent customer support service. So if you have any issues when you're undergoing your ECA evaluation, you can right away contact them and get the answers for your query. So that's why WES is one of the favorites if we talk about ECA. But there's a catch here. WES is quite strict in its evaluation. In fact, WES has stopped recognizing various masters degrees till the time you've done it from one of the elite universities or elite institutes of your country. WES doesn't give you credentials for your master's. So that's why people have started moving towards IQS and CES and various other organizations. So if you want to understand which EC organization you should go ahead with, WES, CES or IQS, I created a video on that. I'll put the link somewhere on the top. You can go check that out. Now we'll talk about what are the prerequisites or the preparation you need to do, which is really important before you apply for WES on their website. First thing is, you should have your passport handy with you. That is very important. Second is, you should have the degrees and mark sheets handy with you. Also, you should know the start date and end date of all the degrees or all the programs that you have already completed. This is really important because you will have to fill in details like your roll number, what was your start date, what was your end date of the program when you actually apply on WES website for ECA evaluation. Last is, you should have your credit card handy and a working credit card, because when you will be done completing all the details on the form, then you'll have to do the payment right there and then, and then only your application will get submitted and you will get the unique reference number. So guys, take care of these prerequisites and keep these documents and details handy with you before you apply for ECA evaluation on the WES website. So in the end, I will be sharing the do's and don'ts which are important for you to consider while you are applying for WES. But right now, let's see what is the process, how step by step can you apply on the WES website. Let me take you to my screen directly. So guys, as a first step, what you need to do is go to wes.org website, and then on this page you will have two options, either to sign in or get started. So sign in is for all the applicants who have already created their profile and they are coming back to check the details, something like that. But since we are creating our profile for the first time, we will go to get started as a new applicant. So I'll click on get started. Here they have told you about three steps which will be required in your ECA. So first is, you need to submit your application, and as you submit your application, you will receive your unique WES reference number. Second is, all the document requirements that once the application is submitted and reference number is generated, your university or college need to send the documents, all the requirement documents, directly to WES organization. Third step is, finally, when WES reviews your documents and finally provide you the credentials and deliver the report to you. Now, for all these steps, first step is to create the application form. So let's go into apply now. I'll click here. It is asking me a question that, where will you use your evaluation? So we are doing it for Canada purpose. So I'll click on Canada. All right. So here you have three options, but since we are creating it for Express Entry program, we'll go into start application directly. The second one. So I'll go into start application. Okay, so guys, here you need to fill in your details. These are basic details. You have to provide all your details. First is, put your first name. Then I'll put the date of birth. So you can put your date of birth, which is on paper. So date of birth actually should be correct. I'll just put something like this.
And then, do you have a West reference number? No, you do not have. No. Then you put your email ID. Enter your email ID and then put the password. So password should be as per the specifications given here. It should be minimum 8 characters or maximum 16 characters with one uppercase and one lowercase letter. One number should be included and one special character should be there. So I'll just put a password, and similarly, you can set a password for yourself. Security question is required, so you can put any security question here. So I'll just put, what is your favorite color? It is good to have a security question, because if by any chance you forget your password, you can reset using your security question. And then you can click on this checkbox button, which is if you would like to subscribe to WS newsletter. So I'll check it here, and then I'll click on create account. It is good to subscribe. You will get to know the latest updates from WS. Now it has taken me to another page where it is already populating the details which I filled in before. So you can validate those details. First name, last name, date of birth is fine, and then put the details which were not filled in the first page. So here I'll put it, and then your country of residence. So I'll put India in my case, and then you can put your address. You can put your telephone number here. You just review all the details that you've put related to email address and then password that you populated, your security question. If you're fine with everything, click on next. Now, on this page, you need to fill in all your education details. So this page is specifically for education. So you have a note here that if you have completed less than 1 year full-time post-secondary study, West recommends that you also send your secondary education credential. Also, read the bullet points mentioned under note here. So for example, if you are also applying for ECA for your spouse, then you need to create a separate application form for your spouse. Your spouse cannot be included in your form. I have already created a video on common queries on ECA related to WES, CES or IQS. I'll put the link in the description box and also on the top in the video. You can check that out as well. Okay, so that's fine. And then now let's add a credential. So whatever education degree you have done, you can add those credentials here. So I'll add my bachelor's here. So I'll quickly go and add the details. So I've done my bachelor's from India. Type of education. It's university education. Then it's going to be bachelor's degree. You can put the name of the institution. So I've put the name of the institution. Then you can put the name of the diploma certificate. First name here will be the same first name that you have in your university or college certificate or transcripts. So for many people, especially women, their surname changes after marriage. So you can put the same name and surname that you have in your degree or college transcripts. So I have entered the first name and last name. Then year awarded. So when you completed your degree, you have to enter that. And then from which year to which year you attended your degree, you have to enter that as well. So now I've entered the years. Now I'll click on save. So here in this form, when you are just putting your credentials for your education, you just need to put year. So keep watching the video. In later stages, you'll have to add your month and year of your education as well in a different certificate. So we'll talk about when we reach there. So I'll click on save here now. So if you have more than one degree, or if you have post graduation or master's degree, you can add it as another credential. So as many degrees you have, you can add them. And if you have any doubt or you want to go back, so here you can edit and go back and edit whatever changes you want to do. But make sure you put the right details. Now we'll go to next. So on this page, it is asking you to add the recipients where you would like WES to send your evaluation report to. So if you see recipient 1 is by default you, it will be the same delivery address, same address that you entered in the previous pages. And second, it is asking you if you want to add any other institution that you would want WES to send your details to. So if you want that, then you can add it as a recipient. If not, then we can proceed ahead. So I don't need to send my degrees or WES evaluation certificates to anywhere else. So I'll not select that. And also there's an additional fee of $30 per institution that you're adding. And this will be $30 plus some shipping and handling charges as well. So I don't want to select this option, so I'll go to next directly. Now it will take you to the page your evaluation. Here it will basically ask you a few details and also give you the details on the cost. So let's see. So it is saying primary purpose for evaluation is immigration. That's correct. And then it's talking about the processing time. So West takes typically 35 business days as per the timeline published on their website. So it is the same. And then your evaluation package will be including all these things, and total fees will be $220. They go to next. Now here it is giving you an option what kind of delivery you want. Do you want it to be standard where there will be no tracking, or do you want a tracking service as well, which is actually currently suspended? It was applicable before COVID. So anyway, just do standard mail and then let's proceed. Now we'll click next. On this page, it will show you all the requirement documents which need to be sent to West for evaluation by your university or college. So here I have entered only one education, so it has highlighted that education. And then it is giving some important piece of information that what kind of certificates or, you know, documents will be required. So it is mentioned here. So majorly it is degree and transcripts need to be sent by your university. Then it will be the requirement checklist. The degree certificate should be there. So it will be either final or provisional if you're already in the last year. Then statement of marks. So this is basically a transcript where all the marks are entered subject wise for each semester per year. So these two important documents are there. Once you complete your application, you will receive a unique reference number, and you need to enter the reference number on the envelope which will be sent to West. That is very important. And never send your original documents. West has clearly mentioned that never send your original documents. There is no responsibility taken by West for that. So always ask your university to issue a fresh transcript, and that should be sent. And this is the courier delivery address where the documents need to be sent. And documents will not be accepted if sent by an individual. So this is also an important disclaimer. Go to next. Now it has taken me to a page where I can review all the details that I've entered in the previous pages. So basically reviewing my application form. This is going to be the final review. If you want to make any changes, you can click on edit button here and make the changes. So quickly we'll review the personal details like first name, last name, date of birth, email ID, mailing address, and then evaluation purpose, education details are here, and the fee details are here, and recipient information are here too. And then you can click on these acknowledgements quickly and then click on next. Here it will ask you to confirm your details again, especially your date of birth, first name and last name. So I confirm everything is right and declared absolutely as per my consent. So I'll click on this button and then I'll confirm. So in our case, on this page, since we are not a resident of Canada, hence we are going for an ECA to apply for immigration. So I'll select that and click on continue. Now it has taken me to the final page where it is declaring all the fee. So if you see, there's a standard delivery of $10, then $220 that we discussed previously, that was the fee mentioned, and then total becomes $230. So on this page, you can do the payment. You can click on credit card and go ahead with your payment. Then click on submit. So once you click on submit, then your unique reference number will be generated. So note down that reference number. Also, you will get an auto-generated email from West as well. So that is important, and that's how you will complete the submission of your ECA form. Next is when the documents will be sent by your university. Along with that, academics records form needs to be sent as well. So I'll show you how the academic records form look like and also what are the details that you need to enter there. So this is how the form looks like. Also, I will leave the link to this academics records form and West website in the description box on the video. So you can go and check that out if you are searching for the link as well. Here you can put in all the details. So see, first detail it is asking for is the reference number. So this document, this form, you might need to send your university or college, and hence they will use this form, put it in the envelope along with other transcripts and degrees and send to West. So here you can put your reference number. This is the same unique reference number which gets generated when you submit your ECA form on West. You can put that unique number here, and then you can put your first name and then last name. So first name and last name should be the same name as on your transcripts. You can put your date of birth here, and then email ID here, your country, You can put your institution name where you did your bachelor's from. So I'm putting the same name that I entered in my West form, then country. So guys, this is the place where you need to enter the months of your education or degree. You can enter starting from which month year till the time of which month and year it got over. So for me, it was August 2006 till June 2010. So enter that. That is the reason I told you that you should have the month's details handy with you. And then you can put the degree name if it is applicable, year of award, and then what was your major, you can put that, and then your roll number, and then you can put your signature and date. So that's it. Section B is basically for you, the authorized officials. You don't need to enter anything here, so you can leave it blank. So this is the form which need to be sent along with your degrees and transcripts when sent to West. This form will be same as number of education degrees you're getting your ECA evaluation done for. So for example, you have one bachelor, so one bachelor's will be one form, and if you have another master's that you have declared, then will be another form for master's. So in total you will have two forms which will be sent to your respective universities. So guys, yeah, that's about it. These are the forms, and this document is important and it needs to be sent along with other transcripts and degrees like I've mentioned multiple times in this video. So in total, this is the process that you need to follow step by step for West application.
Okay, now so what are the do's and don'ts? So guys, always remember that if you're applying through West, you cannot send your transcripts, your mark sheets, your degree to West organization directly. They have strictly said that they will not accept all these degrees transcripts sent by the individuals. Your degrees and transcripts need to be sent only by your universities, and only then it will be accepted by West for evaluation. So it is very important that you check with your universities before you apply with West, that your university should be comfortable and they should be open to sending documents directly to West. Next is the envelope in which all the transcripts and mark sheets and degrees will be sent to West cannot be tampered or damaged. So it should be completely in a good state so that West can consider it for your evaluation. So this is very important. Next very important point again is, do not ever send your original documents, degrees or certificates to West. They have clearly mentioned it on their website that they are not responsible for your original documents, and also if you send them, then there's no guarantee that you will get them back. So keep your original documents safe with you. Never send your original documents to any ECA body for that matter. So yeah guys, that's it. This is about the West process in detail, step by step. I've shared with you with the screen share how you can apply, what are the important documents that are required, and what are do's and don'ts. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, then make sure you give it a big fat thumbs up. And also, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, then please go ahead and click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it, so that you can get all our video notifications. We create a lot of videos on Express Entry program and various other programs that can help you apply for Canada PR. So stay tuned to our channel, click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon if you enjoyed watching this video. And also if you have any questions, then leave a comment for us. We'd love to come back to you. That's it from my end. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, you take care. Goodbye. Stay safe.